Do you have any advice on how to avoid and overcome cravings? How to recover quickly from a day of bad eating?
This is a great question. Okay, so cravings. I mean, cravings are a problem, right? All of us, everyone has cravings. And so it's one of the big benefits, if you will, of following a ketogenic diet, as those elevated ketones really can help cut down on cravings. But when you're first starting on a ketogenic diet, they're still gonna be there for a while. And so what can you do when you're beginning and you start to get those cravings? And that is, look for something that is similar maybe to what you're craving that has a high proportion of fat in it, right? You're, you know, really wanting something sweet. There's plenty of things that you can do with a higher content of fat to combat those cravings and still get that satisfaction. And again, you'll find that those cravings change over time. Not that you still won't crave, but the longer that you've been on a ketogenic diet, once you're fully adapted, the more you'll actually switch to craving things that are actually good for you. You'll have fat cravings. And so at the beginning, look for something that contains fat. Know that it's going to happen initially when you first start, but that those cravings will change over time. And then, are there any common ways to handle it if you have had a bad day? And the answer to that is yes. And these are really things that you need to prepare yourself for ahead of time. I can't stress that enough. Because let's just say you're going on a family vacation and you've got a family vacation spot that you go to and have for years now. And in that family vacation spot is the favorite ice cream place, right? And so you've made this decision ahead of time. You know what? I am going to be making a conscious choice ahead, not getting caught off guard, that I am going to go ahead and have maybe something much smaller than I would have had in the past, but I'm going to enjoy that with my family. How do you take that and keep it from then becoming, well, I might as well have a bad dinner, right? And then it's the next day, well, I blew it for the week, I might as well have a bad day. And so you've got to know ahead of time, conscious choice, and it stops there. The problem with this and the real risk of, well, I've had a bad meal, might as well have a bad day, might as well have a bad week, comes in when that initial time that you went off track was by surprise or out of an urge and not something planned. So plan ahead, and that can really help you police during these times.
But none of us are perfect.
None of us are ever perfect.
If you don't plan ahead, mm-hmm. and you get in that day where it's a really rough day and you fall off track, knowing what's going to happen is really helpful. I think knowing that it might set off more triggers for cravings,
absolutely.
Right? Because your blood sugar is now going up and down, and that's what sets it off. So you kind of have to like hop right back on the wagon, stop it as soon as possible.
Exactly, and do just like we were saying at the beginning with the cravings initially, go back to say, what can I have now that has more fat in it? So you're really gonna utilize some of those principles from the very early days right there and then again to help you get right back on track after a slip, because you're right. And I think that's a really important thing for everyone to know. You don't have to be perfect to be following a ketogenic diet, because no one is perfect. So again, it's learning and developing a whole closet full of strategies to help you out of that situation, not punishing yourself for not attaining that perfection.
And the health coach in me wants to say that an accountability buddy can be really helpful. Just somebody doing this with you that you can kind of report to so that you can get back on track. But I'll end
absolutely,
there.
Absolutely, absolutely. Okay.